me, the five nominees are really an extraordinary group. I mean, it's an international group, which is great. I mean, there's guys that are coming into this for their first nominations and others who've had more than one. I think what was most impressive to me about Avatar was the connection I made with the characters on a very intimate, personal level, where I was able to absorb just the massive vistas and the impressive 3D and the amazing production design, all the facets that went into it. As an audience member, feeling the wonder of being put in this new world and seeing that on the eyes of Sam Worthington or the other actors, that reflected my feelings. I thought that was really, really an effective connection that I had to something that doesn't exist. And when I was moved emotionally, when I was touched and cared about these creatures and their plight, then I knew that it was working for me. And that was, I thought, accomplished extremely well by the editors.
The doors didn't open for 3 months. It just hovered there. Nobody could get in.
I think for District 9, the challenges were the different styles that pervaded the movie from the initial. I mean, I did feel like I was watching CNN. I did feel I was in a documentary, and I was just brought right in. And I said, "Okay, they've established a real situation. I buy it." Then from that intro, beginning to evolve into a story that follows our protagonist's plight. His job and what he does and how he interacts with the prawns. So there's a tremendous amount of versatility that the editor had to display in terms of almost going from one genre to the next and yet being true to them all as far as weaving the documentary aspects into the more human, emotional parts of the movie. The editing of The Hurt Locker was extremely effective in creating tension because I felt, as an audience member, I was as vulnerable as these guys being asked to defuse the bombs. So there was an immediacy, an intimacy of staying with the characters. But when things were cut away, for example, I mean, I just remember one sequence when he's defusing a bomb.
We got a lot of eyes on us, James. We need to get out of here.
Roger that. I'm gonna figure this out.
And he hits a switch, and the windshield wipers just kind of go grrr, grrr. It's just the cut to that, and where you can kind of, but then just kind of exhale. And the style just enhanced the realism of actually being in that situation.
Well, I'm very familiar with you and your family. I have no way of knowing if you are familiar with who I am.
What was so crucial about that movie was there were a lot of really phenomenal scenes, but just the opening in the farmhouse. And in this day and age of having a long dialogue scene in one location with basically just two characters, it's fairly unusual. Yet, because of Christoph's performance and the father and the foreboding and his charm, and yet underneath that, you know, there's a cold-blooded killer, and realizing that in the cellar there, the family was and he wanted them to escape. But that really set the tone for the rest of the movie in terms of who this character was, what his job was, what his goals were, and also setting a tone that you know going into a Tarantino film that there's going to be some unexpected turns, but very compelling. And I look forward to that.
Hey, Precious.
I think for me, Precious was the editor's dream in terms of performance. It really grabbed me by the throat in a good way, and it made me smile to see those fantasy sequences, because the way it was done kind of in a stylistic slow motion way where I could really connect with the eyes and the expression and realizing this was just the complete opposite of where she actually lived. When her mom really unloaded on her. The performance was so powerful. I don't really remember a lot of editing. I just remember, I think it was just basically, you know, there's just two characters, but staying with that woman's tirade and her absolute rage and attack on her daughter. There was a certain simplicity in the way it was staged and cut that allowed the performances to really breathe. And I think that was a really effective way of handling the material. It's an amazing year in terms of contrast and variety, yet at the core, all of them are extremely effective as far as pulling me in. And everything was enhanced for me emotionally by the editorial choices.